वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू सेंट जोसेफ एकेडमीज ऑनलाइन क्लासेस। टुडे वी विल रिवाइज चैप्टर 9, 19 and 20। दीज चैप्टर्स आर स्मॉल इन साइज, so I have combined all these. This is given in your English grammar book of class 1. This chapter 9 is about the use of this, that, these and those. And chapter 19 and 20 are picture comprehension or paragraph writing. So let's start our today's class. With our first slide, you must have understood that our today's topic is about this and that, these and those. So let's start our chapter 9, this, that, these and those. Read the following sentences and look at the pictures carefully. In the first picture, a girl is there. So we have written, this is a girl. In the second picture, a balloon is there. So we have written, that is a balloon. On the right side, in the upper picture, three girls are there, which means more than one. So we have written, these are girls. And the next picture, three balloons are there. So we have written, those are balloons. This is used to indicate or points towards a person, place or thing which is near to us, which is closer to us. And these is used to indicate plural objects, plural persons, persons more than one, or things more than us. More than one, near to us. Things which are near to us but plural in number. We use these for that. That is used to point out at one person, place or thing which is away from us, which is at a distance. And we use those to indicate more than one person, more than one place or more than one thing which is far away from us, which is at a distance from us. In this slide, we will learn the use of these and use of those. The first picture, these are books. These are sandwiches. Both the objects are near to the boy who is pointing at them. And these are plural in number. So we have written these. These are books. These are sandwiches. Now look at the next picture. The objects are at distance from the boy. The objects are far away. The pencils and bananas are away from the child. So what we have written? Those are pencils. Those are bananas. So for the closer plural objects, we use these. And for the plural objects far away from us, we use those. Our first exercise is given on page number 55. Fill in the blanks with the correct words. The first is, dash is my book. For every sentence, we have two options for filling. We have to choose the correct option and write in the blank. In the first picture, the book is closer. So we are pointing towards a closer object which is singular in number. So we will use this. This is my book. Sentence number 2. Dash are his pens. And the options are those and this. Here, if you see carefully, the pens are at a distance from us. And these are pens, not pen. So the object is plural also in number. So things which are far away from us and plural in number, we use those for them. So here we will say those are his pens. Number 3. Dash are your shirts. That, these. Here shirts means the objects are plural but they are close to us. So what should we use, kids? Yes, we use these for plural near objects. So we will say these are your shirts. Number 4. Dash is her umbrella. As you can see, umbrella is at a distance. But it is a singular object, not plural. And what do we use for singular faraway object, students? Yes, we use that. That is her umbrella. See the picture carefully. Fill in the blanks with words given below. Some words are given at the bottom. We have to fill them up according to the requirement and sentence. This, these, that, those. And with that, we have to fill the words pen, flowers, pencils, bag, bananas, grandparents, shoes, sharpener, cat, and flag. The first sentence is, this is a pen. We have written here pen because already from the picture we can recognize that this is a pen. And because this is closer, so we will use this. Those are flowers. Flowers we can see in the picture itself, and those because the flowers are away from us. These are pencils. That is a bag. Bag is away from us but singular, so we have used that. These are bananas. Closer to us but plural in number, so we have used these. Those are my grandparents. Away from us, so we have used those. These are my shoes. As we can see, this is the picture of the shoes, so we have written here shoes and these because the object is closer to us. Dash is my sharpener. This is my sharpener. That is my cat. We have used that because cat is away from us. That is flag. Here flag is singular in number but away from us, so we have used that. Like this you have to complete this exercise in your English grammar book on page number 56. So students, we have already finished our book work. Now this is time for the copy work. Copy work means the work we are supposed to do in our English grammar copy. So the exercise we are going to discuss now and which we will be solving You have to copy this in your English grammar copy. So let's start. This is our copy work which we have to do in our English grammar copy. The exercise is correct the following sentences. As you can see, four sentences are written, but some error has been made in them. Knowingly, something wrong is written. We have to correct that mistake and we have to write these sentences again. In copy also, you will do in the same way. First, you will write the wrong sentence, then you will correct it, and again you will write the correct sentence. These are an apples. Now, these looks odd because we are saying an and then apples. How we can use an with apples? Apples is plural because an means one. So it should be an apple. And why we will use these? It's an one apple, na? Single apple. And for singular we use this. So we will write this is an apple. Number two, these are flowers. These are flower. Now flower is singular. So why we will use these for the singular one? For singular we don't use these, na? For singular we use this. And here are many flowers. If you see in the picture, this is not one flower, many flowers are there. So it's basically a plural. So we will write these are flowers. Number three, those is a tree. Now for singular things which are far away from us, we don't say those is. It's one tree which is far away from us, so we will say that. That is a tree. Number four, that are pencils. Now if pencils are there, it means these are plural. And for plurals, we don't use that. What we will write, kids? Yes, those are pencils. We will use those, not that. So in the same way, you have to write it correctly. So first, we will discuss chapter 19, writing skills. What are writing skills? Writing skills means you read as much as you can. Always keep an English dictionary with you. Dictionary is a small book where all the words are written with their meaning. Check your spellings before writing and after writing. Learn how to write a paragraph. And how you will learn all this? By proper spelling and pronunciation. Good reading. By reading new thing. So writing skills, we improve the way we write, the method of our writing. We understand the words in a better way. So let's see what we are going to do in this chapter. Look at the slide, kids. This is our first paragraph which we have to complete. And the heading is all about myself. As you have already understood, here we have to write about ourselves. Some of the information I have filled, but some information I don't have about you. And it is not possible for me to write the same sentence in 60 different ways. So,
That sentence, that particular sentence about whom I don't have information, I have left for you as a homework so that you can complete it later according to the information. Fill in the following details about yourself. Here we have to fill the information about ourselves. Sentence number one. My name is. This is a homework because here you have to write your own name. Sentence number two. I am dash years old. This is also a homework because your age can differ from each other. So here you have to write your actual age. Number 3. I study in St. Joseph's Academy. I have filled this because all of you study in St. Joseph's Academy. I am in class dash. I am in class first. Most of you are in class first. So here we will write first. My father is a. Here I have written serviceman. If your father is a serviceman, you have to write serviceman. If your father is a businessman, then you have to write a businessman or entrepreneur. My mother is a housewife. If your mother is a housewife, you will write a housewife. Otherwise, you will write whatever profession your mother is in. If she is a teacher, you will write a teacher. If she is a beautician, you will write a beautician. If she is in a job, then write according to that. Sentence number 7. I have dash brothers and dash sisters. I don't know how many brothers and sisters you have, so I have left it blank for homework. You have to do it accordingly. Number 8. I respect my parents, teachers and elders. This will be same for all because this is what we should do. My nationality is Indian. We all are Indians who lives in India. They are called Indians. So I have written here Indian. You will also write the same. My mother tongue is Hindi. If your mother tongue is not Hindi, you can write the language you speak at home. Mother tongue means the language we use to speak at home. That is called mother tongue, or the language, the first language we learn when we start speaking. That's why it is called mother tongue. This is our next paragraph, and the topic is birthday. Write about Amit's birthday. You can choose words from the box. As you can see in the picture, students, this paragraph is about the birthday of a boy whose name is Amit. Words are given in help box. We have to choose the correct word and use it at the correct place. The first sentence is, today is Amit's birthday. This sentence, this paragraph is about birthday. So we will write here birthday. Number 2. Amit has dash his friends to the dash. So what we do on birthdays? We invite our friends. So we will write Amit has invited. And where will he invite his friends to? To his birthday party. His friends to the birthday party. Number 3. His friends have bought many dash for him. What do we take when we go to someone's birthday? Yes, we take gifts for them. So what his friends will bring for him? Gifts. So his friends have bought many gifts for him. Number 4. The room is decorated with dash and dash. As you can see in the picture, the room is decorated with balloons and streamers. As you can see in the picture, there are colorful balloons and Amit's hands also. Number 5. Amit is cutting his birthday dash. What do we cut on birthdays? We cut cake. So here Amit is cutting cake. Number 6. His parents and friends are clapping their hands. What his friends and parents are doing? Clapping. What do we do when someone cuts the cake? We clap and we sing a song, a birthday song. So here we will write clapping. So in picture paragraph, in writing skills, we look at the picture and according to that, we choose a word which we should write in the particular place in the blank. Our next topic is lesson 20, picture reading. Now what should we do on picture reading, kids? Do you have any idea? Yes, I will tell you. The first point we need to take care of while doing picture reading is observation. Observation means you should see carefully. What? What you will see? The picture. The given picture. You will see the name. You will see what that picture is trying to say. What that picture is trying to show. Then question yourself. What you see? What is given in the picture? Go in the details. What are the things in the background? About whom that picture is? Take out the curiosity of yours out. And then create sentences to describe that picture. Create small sentences. So, in this chapter, we will be learning to do picture reading. So, let's start without a delay. This is our first picture paragraph. See carefully. Look at the picture of a school. Complete the sentences with the words given in the help box. Here, half of your work has already been done because it is given in the help box. Now look at the picture carefully. What do you see? This is the entrance of a school. Two kids are going with their backpacks. The peon is ringing the bell. On the left is principal's office and on the right it is the library with lots of books. And inside, as you can see, a teacher is taking a class. So this is how we observe a picture. Now let's see what are the sentences and words are. Students, principal, playground, library, teacher, peon. Now the sentence number 1 is, there are many dash in my school. So what do we have? Many in a school? Students. There are many students in my school. Number 2. My school has a good collection of books in the dash. Where do we have books in the school? You also go in library period to go there and read there. Yes, in the library. We find different books in library. Number 3. The dash is teaching in the class. Who teaches in the class, students? Teacher. A teacher teaches in the class. So we will write here, teacher. The dash is in his office. So who is in the office?
principal. The principal is in his office. There is a large dash in the school. What should be the largest part of our school? Yes, playground. Your favorite place where all the kids or the students loves to play. You do have a very good playground, right? Number 6, the dash is ringing the bell for the interval. Do you remember? In our school also, we always hear the bell. Who rings that? Yes, the school peon rings that bell. About after every period, the school peon rings the bell. The period bell, the lunch bell, and then the bell of the school is getting over. Final bell. You will also fill these words in your book. Our next paragraph, picture of picture reading. First, observe the picture. What is in the picture? A doctor is checking a patient with a stethoscope. One x-ray is hanging behind his wall. A nurse is giving injection to a boy sitting on the bench. Outside the window, an ambulance is parked. So, let's see what are the sentences which we have to complete. A help box is also given. So, work is very easy now. Look at the picture of a doctor's clinic. Complete the sentences with the words given in the box. What are the words given in the box? Stethoscope, doctor, nurse, ambulance, injection, x-ray. We have to complete these sentences with the help of these words. The first one is, this is a doctor in his clinic, because this whole paragraph is about the doctor. And who always found in the clinic? Doctor. Number 2, he is checking a patient with a dash. So, with what we check the patients? Doctors check the patients. And the picture you can see, he is checking a patient with a stethoscope. The thing the doctor keeps in his neck, that is called stethoscope. Number 3, a dash is taking care of sick people. Who takes care of sick people, kids? A nurse. So we will write here nurse. Number 4, there is one ambulance at the gate of the clinic. As you can see in the picture, at the gate of the clinic, one ambulance is parked. Number 5, the nurse is giving a patient an dash. As you can see very clearly in the picture, the nurse is giving an injection to the patient. So here we will write injection. Number 6, the doctor has an x-ray of the lungs of a patient. The doctor is having an x-ray of the lungs of a patient, because that's how doctor finds out if you are having any internal problem. So here we will write x-ray. This is it for today. This was our today's revision. You have to complete all the revision work and the worksheet I will be sending you in your English grammar copy, and revise all of them nicely. Practice them nicely so that you can do them easily when the exam comes. Be prepared and practice nicely. This is it for today. We have learned in this video picture reading, lesson 20 and lesson 19, paragraph writing. We'll meet again with a new video.
Till then, take care of yourself, take care of health, study well, play well. Bye-bye. Have a nice day.